Welcome you all, myself Professor Shilpa Rao from KKVA College of Pharmacy. Today we are going to discuss the topic Recombinant DNA Technology. Learning objectives of today's session. Students should able to understand discovery of this rDNA technology, that is Recombinant DNA Technology, then goals and objectives behind this technique, then actual procedure, then different types of the enzymes used in this technology, then different types of the vectors used in this technology, then techniques of these gene transfer and application of this rDNA technology. Basically, recombinant DNA technology consists of DNA molecules that are extracted from different sources and chemically joined together. For example, DNA comprising an animal gene may be recombined with DNA from a bacterium. Discovery of rDNA technology. The DNA structure discovered by Watson and Crick in 1953, then isolation of DNA ligase in 1967, then isolation of restriction endonucleases in 1970, then in 1972 Paul Berg generated rDNA technology, then Cohen and Boyer in 1973 produced first plasmid vector capable of being replicated within bacterial host. Then outline scheme of these technique. First, selection of desired piece of DNA, then insertion of selected DNA into cloning vector, then introduction of recombinant vector into host, then multiplication and selection of clones containing the recombinant molecules, expression of gene to produce a desired product. This is the outline of this rDNA technology. Then goals of this technique: to isolate and characterize gene which you want to introduce in your host cell, or do you want to recombine with the other fragment of the DNA. Then to make a desired alteration in one or more isolated gene. To return altered genes in living cells. Means after isolation you have to mix it with other fragment of the DNA, then again you have to introduce into the living cell, then artificially synthesize new gene. Alternating the genome of an organism, then understanding the hereditary disease and cure, improving human genome. Then first step, that is the isolation of the DNA. How can you isolate it? By, if you want to isolate it from cell, then you have to extract the cell. How can you extract the cell? Cell are lysed using a detergent that disturbs the plasma membrane. Okay, means what happened? Plasma membrane of the cell broken down. Then cell contents are treated with the protease to destroy protein and RNA to destroy RNA. Then cell debris is pelleted in a centrifuge. The supernal containing the DNA is transported to the clean tube. Okay, here you have to use the two types of the treatment. First, you have to use the enzyme protease for the removal of the protein. And then you have to use the RNAs for the removal of the RNA. Then this enzyme react with this fragment in the cell and settle at the bottom of your tube after centrifugation. And supernal liquid is having a actual DNA fragment. Then you have to transfer it into the another tube. This is your supernal. You have to transfer into the next tube. The DNA is precipitated with ethanol. It forms a viscous strand that can be spooled on a glass rod. DNA can be cut into large fragments by mechanical shearing, restriction enzyme or scissors, and molecular genetic. It's by using these different restriction enzymes, you can cut the fragment of DNA. Then restriction enzyme, a special class of sequence of specific enzyme found in bacteria, site-specific cleave DNA molecule only at a specific nucleotide sequence. Then restriction endonucleases recognize DNA base sequence that are palindrome. Restriction endonuclease make a staggered cut with complementary base sequence for easy circularization. Means after treating your double stranded DNA fragment with restriction enzyme, it forms the sticky end. There are two types of the end, sticky end and blunt end. The sticky end is having a single stranded overhangs, while blunt end cut your DNA fragment at the same place. That's why both the strands are of the double strand. The next, after cutting, you have to introduce into the plasmid, or you have to mix this genetic material of your desired piece of DNA with the plasmid. How can you mix it? This is the foreign DNA. You want this much sequence. By using the restriction enzyme, you have to cut that particular sequence, and the site of cutting is known as the palindromic sequence. At that site only, this enzyme is having the ability to cut the enzyme. Then again, you have to use this restriction endonuclease and cut the plasmid DNA. Then this desired piece of DNA you have to introduce into the plasmid, and joining of this DNA fragment with the DNA fragment of plasmid, that process is known as the annealing, and with the help of DNA ligase, joining of the enzyme is there. Then you have recombinant form of the DNA with you. Then amplifying the recombinant DNA, transforming the recombinant DNA into bacterial host strength. The cell are treated with CaCl2, DNA is added. Cells are heat shocked at 42 degrees centigrade. Then DNA goes into cell by somewhat unknown mechanism. Once in a cell, the recombinant DNA will be replicated. When the cell divides, the replicated recombinant molecule go to both daughter cells, which themselves will divide later. Thus, DNA is amplified. Means as you have this recombinant DNA with you, then you have to introduce into the specific host cell. By treating this cell with the CaCl2, then because of this heat shock, there is generation of pore, and through this pore, this fragment of DNA entered into the cell. Then there is an amplification of this DNA fragment and its recombinant form transferred into the daughter cell. So this is the vector DNA. This vector form you have to introduce into the host cell, and then further dividation and amplification of the recombinant DNA. Then different enzymes used, ligase is used to bind the DNA molecule, to join the DNA molecules. Then type 2 restriction endonuclease used to cleave the specific site. Then reverse transcriptase used to make a copy of RNA molecule. Then DNA polymerase 1 fill single strand gap of DNA duplex. Then polynucleotide kinase add a phosphate to 5-hydroxy end of the polynucleotide. Then terminal transferase add homopolymeryl at 3-hydroxy end. Then exonuclease 3 remove nucleotide residue from 3- end. Then bacteriophage exonuclease remove nucleotide from 5' end, and last alkaline phosphatase remove terminal phosphate group. In vectors used in rDNA technology, the vector is an area of DNA that can join another DNA part without losing limit of self replication. Okay, plasmid is the example of vector. It is having the ability to self-replicate independent of the cell material or cell genetic material. It should be capable of replicating in a host cell independently. It should have a convenient restriction endonuclease site for inserting DNA of interest. Means by using this restriction endonuclease sites, this enzyme cut the fragment of DNA of plasmid and your desired form get bind to that particular site. It should have a selected marker to indicate which host cell received the recombinant DNA molecule. Means selectivity of the host cell is there. It should be small and easy to isolate. These are the example of different vectors: plasmid, then lambda phage, cosmid, then expression, then yeast artificial chromosome, then bacterial artificial chromosome. These are the different examples. Then we'll move to the first part, that is the plasmid vector. It is the small circular DNA molecule that are separated from the rest of the chromosome. Means if you see the bacterial cell, the genetic material of bacteria is separated from this plasmid, and this plasmid is having the ability to self-replicate independently. They replicate independently and of the bacterial chromosome, useful for cloning DNA insert less than 20 kilobase pair. Insert larger than 20 kilobase pair are lost easily in bacterial cell. Means it is having the limitation of how much sequence it can carry, or how much length of DNA fragment joined with this plasmid vector and transferred into the host cell. Then lambda phage vector is a recombinant infections containing phage chromosome in addition to embedded outside the DNA. In all phage vectors are convey bigger DNA groupings than plasmid vector. Means by using this plasmid vector, rDNA fragment is introduced into the host cell and it is having the ability to carry the long fragment of the DNA. Then cosmid vector are hybrid of phages and plasmid that can carry DNA fragment up to 45 kilobase pair. As compared with the plasmid, it is having the ability to carry the long DNA fragment. They can replicate like a plasmid but can be packed like phage lambda. Means it is having the ability of it is having a characteristic of previous both vectors, that is self-replication like plasmid and packaging of the DNA fragment like the phage lambda. Then expression vectors are vectors that carry host signals that facilitate the transcription and translation of inserted gene. They are very useful for expressing eukaryotic genes in bacteria. Then next is the yeast artificial chromosome. Yeast artificial chromosome are yeast vectors that have been engineered to contain a centromere, telomere, origin of replication and selectable marker. They can carry up to 1000 kilobase pair of DNA fragment, which it is having the ability to carry the long fragment of the DNA. They are useful for cloning eukaryotic genes that contain introns. Next part is the bacterial artificial chromosomes. are bacterial plasmids derived from F plasmid. They are capable of carrying up to 300 kilobase pair of DNA fragment. Means if you see all the vectors, each artificial chromosome is having the ability to carry the long fragment of the DNA as compared to other vector. Next, methods of the gene transfer. Now you have your recombinant form of the DNA with you. How can you insert it into the cells? These are the different methods of insertion of this gene or transfer of this gene. First is the transformation. Is a method of introducing foreign DNA into bacterial cell. Say for example, E. coli. Uptake of plasmid DNA by E. coli is carried out in ice cold CaCl2, that is calcium fluoride, and a subsequent heat shock. Means you have to keep the cells into the ice cold water and just you have to suddenly increase the temperature, and because of this heat shock, for the fraction of second, or because of this heat shock for the particular time, generate the pores on the surface of that cell, and through this cell insertion of the gene is there. Second, conjugation, a natural microbial recombination process. During conjugation, two live bacteria come together, joined by cytoplasmic bridge, and transfer a single stranded DNA. Inside recipient cell, new DNA may integrate with chromosome or many remain free. Then electroporation, it is a technique involved electric field mediated membrane permeabilization. Electric shocks can be also induce cellular uptake of exogenous DNA fragment suspending into the solution. It is a simple and rapid technique for introducing gene into the cell. Means electroporation means just you have to generate the pore on the surface of cell by using the electric current, and the cells are kept into the suspension, and this suspension is also having your rDNA fragment, and because of this electric shock, this fragment entered into the cell. That is electroporation. Then direct transfer of DNA. By using this microinjection and particle bombardment, these are the two techniques helpful to transfer the DNA fragment directly into the cell. Then liposome mediated gene transfer. Liposomes are circular lipid molecules which have an aqueous interior that can carry nucleic acid. Several techniques have been developed to encapsulate DNA in liposomes. The liposome mediated gene transfer is referred to as lipofection. Treatment of DNA fragment with liposome, DNA piece get encapsulated inside the liposome. This liposome can adhere to cell membrane and fuse with them to transfer the DNA fragment. The DNA entered the cell and to the nucleus. Positively charged liposome efficiently complex with DNA bind to the cell and transfer the DNA into the cell. Means liposome is the lipid molecule. Within that lipid molecule, you have to fill or you have to insert the recombinant DNA, and it is having the ability to adhere the cell surface, and then entry of this that rDNA into the cell. Then different types of the host cells. Host are the living system or cell in which carrier of recombinant DNA molecule or vector can be propagated. There are different types of the host cell, prokaryotic and eukaryotic. In prokaryotic, bacteria, say for example E. coli, Bacillus subtilis, Streptomyces. Then in a eukaryotic group, different fungal species are used as a host. Saccharomyces cerevisiae, then Aspergillus nidulans, then animal cells like insect cells, oocytes, then mammalian cells are also used as the host cell. Then plant cells, for example, protoplast and intact cells are also used. then applications of genetic engineering in medicine. Genetic engineering, also called genetic modification, is a direct manipulation of organism genome using biotechnology or by using rDNA technology. Means you can manipulate the gene sequence by using this technique, and desired characteristic you can introduce into the animals and plants. It is a set of technologies used to change a genetic makeup of cell, including transfer of genes within and across species boundaries to produce improved or novel organisms. rDNA technology is a technology that used to cut a known DNA sequence from one organism and introduce into another organism, thereby altering genotype of recipients. Why genetic engineering is done? This genetic engineering is when the genetic makeup of an organism is altered by inserting, deleting, or changing specific piece of DNA. When conducting genetic engineering, the organism that have their genetic makeup altered are referred to as genetically modified organism or GMO. Application in molecular biology for gene mapping, then for the determination of genetic disorder, then production of monoclonal antibodies, gene therapy, DNA fingerprinting, then in vaccine production and in pharma products. If you see the gene mapping, it is also called linkage mapping, can offer firm evidence that disease transmitted from parent to child is linked to one or more genes. Mapping is also provide clue about the chromosome contain a gene and precisely where the gene lies on that chromosome. Then chromosome mapping is a technique used to autosomal DNA testing, which allows to determine which segment of DNA came from which ancestor. In order to map DNA segment on a specific chromosome, it is necessary to test a number of close family relatives. Means, if any genetic disorder is there, then this disorder is entered because of which, you can say, parent, either it is mother or father. By using this gene mapping, you can determine who is responsible for this transmitted disease. Then genetic disorder that caused by an abnormality in an individual DNA. Abnormalities can be also as small as single base mutation in just one gene, and they can involve the addition and subtraction of entire chromosome. Most common disorders, that is cystic fibrosis and Down syndrome. Then in production of monoclonal antibodies, most commonly these antibodies are used to treat the cancer. One way the immune system attack the foreign substance to body is making a large number of antibodies. And an antibody is a protein that stick to specific protein called antigen. Antibodies circulate throughout the body until they find and attach to antigen. The monoclonal antibody used in a wide variety of ways. They are used in a pregnancy test kits to identify small level of hormone called HCG, that is human chorionic gonadotropic hormone, which is present in the urine of pregnant women. They can also be used to locate blood clots as they bind to clot. Then next application, that is DNA fingerprinting. It is a technique used specially for identification by extracting and identifying the base pair pattern of an individual DNA, called also DNA typing, genetic fingerprinting. DNA fingerprinting image caption. In this technique, scientists collect the sample of DNA from different sources. For example, from hair left behind at the crime scene, from blood of victim and suspects. They then narrow in the stretch of repetitive DNA scattered throughout these samples. Then in vaccine production, vaccine is the product that produces immunity from disease and can be administered through needle injection or by mouth or by aerosol. A vaccination is injection of killed or weakened organism that produces the immunity in the body against that particular organism. An antigen is a chemical substance that will trigger an immune response in human body, and this will cause the body to produce antibodies. Usually the virus protein or weakened virus are used as a vaccine antigen. And there are different manufacturing methods used to produce antigen for vaccine. Means for the large scale production of these microorganisms which are used in the production of vaccine, by using this rDNA technology, the large production of the particular bacterial species is there. Then pharma products. A pharmaceutical drug is a drug used to diagnose, cure and treat or prevent disease. Drug therapy is an important part of medical field and relies on the scene of pharmacology for continual advancement and on a pharmacy for appropriate management. For example, antibodies and enzymes. So this is all about the rDNA technology. Thank you.